Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today. We'll start with Psyche spacecraft arriving at Florida launch site, followed by the threat that SpaceX Starbase poses to endangered species, and we'll wrap up with 150,000 daily users using Starlink in Ukraine. So let's begin with an update on Psyche spacecraft, which arrived in Florida for the SpaceX Falcon Heavy launch later this year. Psyche, one of the most awaited scientific missions of NASA that plans to send a 2,600-kilogram spacecraft to study the Psyche asteroid, which is not only very far from Earth, but also assumed to have full of metallic deposits. The Psyche mission is probably going to mark NASA's first operative use of the SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket, though USS F-44 is also in almost nearby time. As per recent reports, almost after a period of over 3 years, Cape Canaveral, Florida launch site has again received a payload for the Falcon Heavy rocket, and that payload is the Psyche spacecraft. Reports say that on the 29th of April, 2022, NASA's Launch Service Program publicized that the Psyche spaceship has finished its journey from the Jet Propulsion Laboratory's Pasadena, California assembly facilities to Kennedy Space Center in Florida. NASA's Launch Services Program tweeted, "Mission to Psyche arrives at NASA Kennedy's launch and landing facility. Psyche will journey to a metal-rich asteroid between Mars and Jupiter to investigate iron core. Launch targeted for August 1, 2022. It took years of toil and labor for the design, manufacturing, and assembly of the Psyche spacecraft. Now it seems as the assembled spacecraft has finally reached the launch facility on time. It's expected that the launch of Falcon Heavy will be on its usual track, which is scheduled on the 1st of August later this year. In the present scenario, it seems that Psyche launch may happen before the USS F-44 mission, as the USS F-44 mission faced repeated delays in recent times. For both the Psyche mission and USS F-44, SpaceX will use brand new core and side boosters, as well as a new upper stage with new fairings. As this mission requires high performance for each mission, and as both will be the first operational use of the Falcon Heavy rocket for NASA and the USSF, thus SpaceX will expend the center core of those Falcon Heavy rockets. If the launch of USS F-44 remains on track, then it will make SpaceX complete Falcon Heavy's first direct launch to geostationary orbit. For this purpose, the rocket's upper stage will have to survive approximately 360 minutes of coasting phase and perform a prolonged orbit circularization burn around 42,500 kilometers above Earth's surface. Psyche, on the other hand, will be shot into deep space on a particular trajectory that NASA has calculated out with the help from SpaceX. And at that trajectory, Falcon Heavy can launch more than 4 tons and can still recover all 3 boosters. In our next update, we'll see how much SpaceX Starbase activities pose a threat to endangered species around the Texas factory. SpaceX has been carrying forward their Starbase development work in good deal, but we know such a work of huge impact will require license approvals to be legalized, and thus SpaceX is hunting for the approval for quite a long time. In this case, we know the Federal Aviation Administration will be the main decision maker and will finally provide the launch approval to SpaceX, but it's part of FAA's rule to have a discussion with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service to ensure how much this sort of rocket development activities would affect the environment and species of that area, or whether the activities violate the Endangered Species Act or not. And as per reports, the FAA has recently carried out a similar consultation with the Fish and Wildlife Service regarding SpaceX's Starship development activities in Boca Chica Starbase. Report says, after that discussion, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service has released a document which stated that SpaceX will have to monitor their Starbase activities, close observation of affected animal populations carefully, and lessen their effect on endangered species and their habitat, limit construction and launch activity to specific seasons or times of day and night, to get the testing and launch approvals from the FAA. The documents released by the federal agency had also pointed out the current decline of an endangered bird species named the piping plover. As per the documents, SpaceX plans to have a reduced energy generation in their natural gas power plant than they've planned earlier for the sake of lessening impact on the environment. In a draft biological and conference opinion (BOC), the Fish and Wildlife Service stated that the plans of SpaceX Starbase will affect some of the species protected under the Endangered Species Act. They also state that hundreds of acres of their critical habitat will be affected from Starship activities in Texas. But in a hopeful note, the agency stated that this will not make the species extinct, though it is threatened to a great extent. The draft stated that around the SpaceX Texas facility, there is almost 903.65 acres of main habitat area for the piping plover bird. And of those 903.65 acres, 446.27 acres of habitat will become lost due to SpaceX activities. The other threatened species are red knot, jaguarundi, and ocelot. Report says that the SpaceX activities will impact the migration, mating, health, and habitat of the species. Also, the excessive traffic, construction and rocket test sounds, explosions, division of habitat by numerous construction activities, all will have major influence on the life of this species. Sources state that sea turtles, too, are not completely safe from these Starbase activities. The Fish and Wildlife Service has submitted to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration for carrying out study on effects of SpaceX activities on marine life. Kemp's Ridley sea turtle of Boca Chica is the most critically endangered sea turtle in the world. Last year, SpaceX sent its most recent proposal for the Boca Chica facility to the FAA. That proposal consisted of building a new launch pad, new landing pad, power plant, natural gas processing facilities, and water infrastructure, including deluge systems and retention ponds used for cooling the launch pad. The area on which SpaceX has its present Starship facility is surrounded by wildlife refuge areas, so environmental impact is itself a greater deal here. If SpaceX fails to get the license approvals for the Starbase facility, then they'll have to settle on any other place for this project. In fact, earlier in February 2022, Musk had proposed having a Starship launch facility in Florida and turning the Boca Chica facility into a research and development site. So this may become an option for SpaceX. But still, these draft opinions from Fish and Wildlife Service will be a favorable opinion to SpaceX, as the agency only requires very little amount of spending for conservation and other obligations by SpaceX. Jared Margulis, senior attorney with the Center for Biological Diversity, said, "It seems the Fish and Wildlife Service is bending over backwards to figure out a way to permit more of what's been a very detrimental use of the Boca Chica site as far as impacts to wildlife go." Margulis stated that SpaceX didn't have to make any larger commitment to the FWS agency for the conservation of the species. SpaceX is only required to donate a meager $5,000 to an ocelot conservation group per year. "This is a company with very deep pockets. The least they could do is address these harms in a meaningful way," said Margulis. We will conclude with SpaceX's Starlink having 150,000 daily users in Ukraine, on average, after activation in March. SpaceX's growing Starlink constellation is fast collecting numerous users all around the world, and presently the focus is on the Ukrainian Starlink users. After the Russia-Ukraine conflict had started, the Ukrainian government had sought help from Musk to provide strong satellite internet connectivity there, as they were concerned Russia's invasion could disrupt Ukraine's internet services. Within a short time, numerous user terminals were sent to the war-devastated Ukraine. On the 27th of March, the Starlink service in Ukraine was activated. Almost 5 weeks have passed since activation. Within this short time, Starlink has got almost 150,000 daily users there. Mikhail Fedorov, Ukraine's vice prime minister, in a recent tweet, announced this number of daily users. He wrote, "Rough data on Starlink's usage, around 150,000 active users per day. This is crucial support for Ukraine's infrastructure and restoring the destroyed territories. Ukraine will stay connected no matter what." As per reports, Ukraine has almost 10,000 Starlink user terminals working, up and running in the country. From the tweet of Fedorov, it's clear that this strong internet connection is helping in a good deal for restoring the devastated regions. In late March, Fedorov stated that Ukraine was using thousands of Starlink terminals. Some source reports confirmed that almost 5,000 Starlink terminals are under use in Ukraine. And presently, in the early of May, the number of terminals has just doubled. This shows how fast SpaceX is able to carry out the distribution process of their Starlink user terminals around the world, giving a glimpse of their rapid productive capability.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.